Today at Executive Chat, we're going to meet Cristina Messa, Minister of University and Research in the Italian government. Minister Messa, thank you so much for visiting Bocconi University at the beginning of the academic year 21-22.
Well, thank you. It's a real pleasure and honor to be here.
So let me get started with a question that leverages on your expertise as a professor of medicine. The recent pandemic has demonstrated the importance of integration between disciplines, sometimes very distant one from the other, for example, medicine and economics. Can you share with us what we have to expect from Italy and Europe in general to try to integrate more the different disciplines in academia?
Well, I guess that the academia has really to change a little bit the way the teaching is performed and organized. We need to mix as much as possible different disciplines in new courses, in new teaching for the youngest who have to face a world with a lot of complexity. And in order to face the complexity, we need something different than what we have now.
Absolutely. And speaking about the pandemic, there's also been a deep dive into remote teaching and distance learning. How do you see remote teaching in the future?
Well, remote teaching, I think, is a very useful way to get all the people involved in teaching, also people who are not able to be present, because that can happen. And also it can reach many, many people. So it can be devoted also to large population, and that is very important and useful. So I think it will be a complementary method with teaching in presence for many different activities.
Minister, the Next Gen EU plan and also the Italian Recovery and Resilience Plan are putting a lot of attention to applied and basic research. How do you see the world of research in 2026 when the plan will be completed?
Well, I really hope that we are going to have a research community that has many actors that are researchers, but also private researchers, also people involved in technology, and that the transfer of results of the research that should be more than now, because they are financed today, more rapidly transferred to the world of business. So that's really what I hope is going to happen. And it creates a circle that maintains itself in a very sustainable way.
That's brilliant. So we're living in the knowledge society, but we still have relatively a number of graduate students, which is low. And in Italy, for example, despite the fact that we have a public system and so the cost is relatively limited, not so many graduates compared also to other G8 and EU state members. What can we do to convince students after school to continue investing in education?
Well, first of all, we have to make a link between their vocation and their studies with the jobs, the future jobs. I think that in Italy, many families decide not to send their boys and girls to university because they are afraid that that is a little bit useless in terms of future life. So, but the society needs graduates. They really need a lot of graduates, much more than what we are doing now. So I think that we have to help students in decision making when they are at school, high school, for example, but also to work on the link between university and the jobs world.
Let me conclude with a final question on the diversity gap. Before becoming minister, you have been one of the first female rector in a university in Italy, and I guess also one of the first female rector in Europe in general. So what can we do in academia in order to close the gender gap, particularly in STEM disciplines, for example, which still have a huge gender gap?
Well, female rectors are few because professor, full professor, women full professor are few, and so it's a chain. So we have to work from the real beginning. First of all, trying to help women in choosing STEM, because that is a stereotype that women choose more humanistic study than none, but that is not actually true. Second is trying to help women in having their career and find the good compromise between career and family, because that is still a big problem for women in Italy as well.
This makes a lot of sense. And Minister Messa, let me thank you so much for visiting Bocconi University, and I wish to invite you again in the future in front of all our students.
Well, thank you again, Rector Verona, and I really wish all the best for the next season.